For years now, the trend of politics in Uganda has been taking another dimension that demands that one needs to spend copious amounts of money to join politics and stay there as well. 14 civil society organizations came together and carried out a survey between November and December 2014, targeting a population of 275 directly elected MPs. The findings in this report called Parliamentary Attitudes to Vote Buying and Selling show that 73% of MPs want a limited amount of money spent by presidential candidates, while 62% want cap on money spent by parliamentary candidates.
The ripple effect is one that when a member of parliament does come and they, you know, pay you money in order for them to go to parliament, remember that the first thing they will do is recoup. They won't actually mind about service delivery. The first thing that, I mean, we've already seen that most of them, the first thing that they try to do is to increase their emoluments. Now, where do the emoluments come from? They come from the consolidated fund. And if monies are coming from the consolidated fund, services are going to be very poor.
The findings also indicate that 79% of MPs said that personal finances are an important source for financing election campaigns. 39% of the legislators said that donations are the second most important source for financing campaigns. The Alliance for Campaign Finance Monitoring points out that this trend is a big problem and that if not urgently addressed, it will affect the ability to efficiently deliver services.
The spillover effect is the quality of service delivery.
The group is also agitating for a law that will handle this practice.
For the enactment of an independent legislation that will ensure that the amount of monies that are spent during elections are capped, to ensure that these financial declarations of monies that people spend.
Commercialization of politics is common in African countries, but why? Peter Wandera, the executive director of Transparency International, says it all starts with the attitude we harbor towards the situation.
Person's attitude is quite difficult. The MPs expect to do so. The public also expects money from the MPs. So if we don't deal with the attitude, most likely we shan't be successful in stopping this practice of commercializing politics.
Last week, Alliance for Campaign Finance Monitoring released a report which reveals that on average, an MP spends over 4 million shillings on each visit to his or her constituents. Maurice Ochol, NTV.